Thanks for tuning in. I'm Linaya Fuller.
And I'm Eshk Salem.
And this is Good Day Forest Hills.
Our first fall 2023 episode.
That's right, we're back.
And we are your new anchors from the Senior Drama Academy.
The first month of school went by fast, and now we're in October.
Yes, Lanai, get the pumpkin latte, sweaters, and apple picking ready. Hopefully all that rain is done.
Starting fresh is very important, and on that note, we have an exclusive interview with our principal for some welcoming words.
This is Jack Fernandez for Good Day Forest Hills, and I'm going to catch up with the principal. Let's go. Thank you for being with us today, Mr. Wilbur. How will this year be different? What can we expect?
I'm really excited about this year. I think this is an opportunity for us to really get involved in school. So this year is going to be different because we're going to see more students trying harder to find clubs, to get involved in sports, and to do extra work in their classes where they're making the class a living experience for themselves. I'm excited about this year.
What is your goal for this school year?
My goal for this year is to have students speaking about that learning more, overcoming some of their insecurities or fears, or just taking advantage of the opportunity to have somebody in a non-judgmental environment to share their ideas of whatever they've been learning.
What is the most important job as a principal?
Well, as a principal, I have found that there are a lot of things I should pay attention to, but the thing that's most important is that I'm greeting students and that we're making connections with students. As an adult in the building, those connections are really important. You know, if there's something that defines our mission as educators, it has to be that we're making connections with the youth that we work with every day.
Can you give the students something to think about or some words of encouragement?
Words of encouragement are that your ideas are valid, that you deserve the opportunity to speak about those ideas, and that you need to take a deep breath, realize that we're all here to learn, and that we will learn from you, but we need to hear your voice.
Do you have a message to the parents?
Yeah, to our parents. I want to make sure that our parents understand how the youth are engaging in schools, and that they are partners in this process for us.
Well, thank you for being with us here today, Mr. Wilbur. Here, to a successful school year. This was Jack Fernandez with Good Day Forest Hills, and now back to the studio.
Thank you, Mr. Wilbur. Looking forward to seeing you in the halls.
Next up, it's only the start of the school year, but sports are in full swing.
Let's see what teams are playing like pros.
Our sports reporters, Gianna and Jaina, caught up with soccer, and they here track down cross country.
This is Justin with Jaina
and Gianna, and we're catching up with the boys' soccer team.
They are currently undefeated. Let's check them out. Yeah! Mr. Hove, so how is the team doing this year?
So far, they're undefeated. They're 6-0. And the amazing part about this year is they have not let one goal in.
I'm here with the captain of the team.
Christian Hernandez.
What is the captain's job?
The captain's job is to be a role model to the team and set an example, whether it's outside the field and inside in the field, to demonstrate leadership towards everyone on the team.
So I'm here with
Patrick Hernandez.
Patrick, what position do you play on the team?
I'm naturally a goalie, but for Forest Hills, I play as a winger. Just, you know, it's too easy for me.
What makes the team so special this year?
We have an excellent group of players, very talented at all levels. For every position, there's a very talented player. So it's really special. They're clicking very well. The defense is awesome. The offense is awesome. And so is the midfield.
1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6. All right.
So what is the goal for the team this year? And do you think they'll go further than last year's team?
The goal is always to win the championship, but we like to take it game by game, step by step. So we accomplished our first goal, which is getting into the playoffs. Now we want to win the division. And then, we want to win the championship.
Good luck to the soccer team. How does it feel to be back here in Forest Hills High School?
It feels good. Like home. I grew up here, so it's good to be back.
What are you doing now with your soccer career?
I'm playing at Iona College, Division 1.
I'm here with
Lorenzo.
Why do you love playing soccer?
I love playing soccer just because when I play, I feel free. All my problems go away.
So, Diego, what is your position that you play on the team?
I play as a midfielder, and my specialty is mostly like passing, shooting, in the middle.
So, are you good at it?
Yeah, I'm good.
Hope to see it on the field. I'm here with
Tim.
How can someone become a better soccer player?
They have to train, they have to dedicate their life to it, and they have to lock in.
So, Edgar, why do you love playing soccer?
Well, I love playing soccer because ever since a kid, I loved watching it with my mom, my dad, my whole family, basically. You know, the passion my whole family has for this sport, like growing up with it.
I'm here with
Hugo Noguera.
How could someone become a better soccer player?
To be a better soccer player, you need to be motivated and disciplined every day.
So, Angelo, what position do you play on the team?
I play a center mid or a center attacking mid.
And why is it important?
It's important because you have to transition to defense to offense, and you have to lead the play.
And now it's
halftime, where we learn skills from your favorite teams here at Forest Hills High School. Let's go, Rangers!
What skill are we going to learn today?
I mean, it's pretty much some basic juggling and the around the world.
How hard is this skill to execute?
I mean, it's pretty simple. All it takes is practice.
This was Jaina
and Gianna saying, go Rangers! Thank you, soccer team!
Woo! This is Nihir Satine catching up with the girls and boys cross country. Let's check them out. How do you feel about the team's strengths this year?
This year we're looking really good. We're coming back. We're the defending champions. And our goal is to come back and try to win it again this year.
What does the team hope to accomplish this year?
We're actually trying to get to our three-peat. We've won the last 2 years, and we're looking to win both races, the JV race and the varsity race as well.
We have a chance to make school history with our third Queen's Championship.
What's some advice you could give to somebody joining the team?
My big thing with the guys, and I tell this to everybody, I had this conversation yesterday, follow directions. Don't impress me by trying to run fast when I tell you to run slow. Just follow directions and show up every day.
How do you feel about the team's strengths this year?
I feel really good. I think we're going to have a nice, strong team going into this Saturday's meet. We have some new faces and some girls that return, so we're going to do great.
What does the team hope to accomplish this year?
Well, we want to be Queen's champs. That's number one. And hopefully some of the girls can get to cities, and maybe a couple might even make it to states. So we do have some strong runners on the team. But most importantly, we want to beat the other team's Queen's schools to become Queen's champ.
I'm here with
Kiel
and
Isabella.
Why do you love this sport?
Because my teammates, I love them all, and they're like a family to me.
That's a great answer. Why do you love this?
I'd say the same thing. I mean, all my friends are on here, and it's like just a good environment to bond with other people and meet people.
What is the captain's job?
To inspire the rising juniors, sophomores, and freshmen to be like me and do their best.
What about you? What do you think the captain's job is?
It's to create a really good environment with everyone, good relationships, but also at the same time, have everyone like be dedicated and like committed to a team and be able to balance like academics and sports at the same time.
Okay, I'm here with the freshmen from the cross country team. This is
Alexander Alvarez
and
Ashley Aracena.
Wow, how excited are you guys to be here?
Pretty excited. This is
my seventh practice.
How do you feel?
To be honest, I'm in pain. But cross country, we run rain or shine every day so we can get better and progress.
Yeah, work hard, play hard, am I right? What's some advice you could give to somebody joining the team?
Sticking with it. That's the hardest thing because distance running is not easy. And when everyone hears they have to run 3.1 miles, they think, oh my God, I can't do that. But once they stick with it, then it's, you know, really worth it. They can see their accomplishments and their growth over the year.
What do you think the team hopes to accomplish?
We get a trophy. We're going to have a bunch of like meets and things like that, and I hope that we win and we bring more trophies, because last year the sophomores got a group run trophy and now we have to live up to that.
Go Rangers! This was Nahir Satin reporting from Good Day Forest Hills. Go Rangers!
Next up, we welcome the freshman class who made it to our school. They are the chosen ones indeed.
Let's go to Ariana with a group of freshmen, the future class of 2027.
Hello, my name is Ariana Baez and I am here with this year's freshmen. Say hello, class of 2027. Let's hear what these freshmen have to say.
How do you feel finally being in high school?
It's actually a lot easier than I thought it would be, and it's a lot more fun. The work's a lot more easier, surprisingly.
I feel responsible and very, like, yeah, responsible.
James, and it's really exciting, just all these new opportunities, such as the clubs and the sports, and just really exciting.
So what are some worries you guys have now being in high school?
My name is Michael, and some worries I have is just getting to class on time and, like, to do homework and, like, get it in by when it's due.
Yeah, the workload definitely does increase, and the school is very big.
Hi, my name is Sophia. One worry that I have is definitely making new friends and if I'm going to be well-adjusted in the school, but I'm sure once everything is settled, I'll be fine. I still have 3 more years to go, so...
I also believe that. You'll definitely make friends.
I'm Ava. A worry that I have is probably keeping up with the heavy workload and kind of the pressure of just being in a new setting is a little scary, but I'll get used to it.
You definitely will. It's something you grow accustomed to after time. So what are you guys looking forward to?
I'm looking forward to joining more drama productions and doing acting, singing, dancing, and all that. So yeah.
That's great. Our school has a lot of opportunities for that. I hope to see you on stage.
I'm looking forward to accomplishing all the tasks that I wanted, like joining extracurricular activities and hiring my GPA, since that's something that colleges look for.
Very smart idea. Our school has a ton of extracurriculars.
My name is Sahil Arora, and what I'm looking forward to is getting good enough grades to make it into an AP class and making the JV basketball team.
I hope you accomplish that, and I'll see you on the court. Thank you, freshmen, and good luck on your first year. Now back to you at the studio.
And here's our new advice corner with Emily Squared.
Oh, hi. Welcome to Emily Squared Advice Corner. I'm Emily Peralta.
And I'm Emily Savalla.
And we are... Emily Squared. It's the start of a school year, and we're answering letters of worry. Let's hear our first letter. Dear Emily Squared, I've been struggling to make friends. Do you have any suggestions? It's scary to talk to new people, but I want to make some friends. Signed, Lonely Girl 222. Hey there, Lonely Girl. Think about starting a conversation with someone you sit next to in class. Talk about your summer or an upcoming assignment. Comment on something they are wearing, like a cute t-shirt. Ask about a movie or a game coming out. Go up to someone who seems shy also and ask, what are you doing this weekend?
Yes, and look out to join clubs and a team, maybe. Then you go meet someone with your interests. Mm-hmm. Lonely girl, I feel like the best solutions to your problem is to just put yourself out there. Let's check out another letter. Dear Emily Square, there's something that has not been that has been stressing me out, and it's all the work I have been getting. I just wonder, how do you balance it all and find time to complete all your work on time? Signed, overwhelmed.
Well, hard work will eventually pay off. Try to designate an hour or two a day just for work. Have a good rest when you get home, eat some dinner, and then tackle that work.
Definitely use your phone calendar to put in due dates. Reminders are good tools also. Don't forget to have one day on the weekend just to have fun.
I hope that helped. That's all the letters we have time for today. Now it's time for the quote of the month. For now, laugh at confusion, smile through the tears, be strong, and keep reminding yourself that everything happens for a reason. John Mayer.
Join us again next month for more
Emily Squared.
Next, we have another treat for everybody.
Let's see our new In the Halls with Jeremiah Million called
Just the Jam.
In this segment, he catches up with students and staff to see their thoughts on the questions of the month. Did he get you? Let's see.
Take it away, Jeremiah.
Hey, this is Just the Jam with Jeremiah, and we're back in full swing and fall is on. Let's see how people are feeling. Grab your punch, Ginge drinks. Let's kick it off. Let's go. Excuse me? Sheena, all right. What's your favorite thing about fall?
All right, I have to say my favorite thing is the weather. Like, I have so many nice outfits for fall, and my style fits best in the weather, so yeah.
Peep the fit. Oh, shoot. Peep the fit. Oh, shoot. Okay. AP Christopher E. Banks, what is your favorite thing about fall?
Ooh, the start of sports. From football to ice hockey to playoffs to NBA.
What is your favorite thing about fall, Nicholas?
About fall? It has to be the weather.
The weather?
About the weather. Winter, too cold. Summer, too hot.
What is your favorite thing about fall, Michael?
Wearing sweaters, probably, and watching scary movies.
I love the scenery of, like, the leaves and, like, how, like, the trees look so pretty and, like, everything just looks so, like, I love fall.
I don't have a favorite thing about fall. I don't really like fall, I'm not going to lie.
What's your favorite thing about fall?
The vibe, the orange theme, orange, yellow, yeah.
I really like how the leaves turn orange, and I just like the fall vibes, and Halloween is like my favorite season.
Summer vacation seems so long ago. What'd you do in summer?
Honestly, summer was really productive for me. I just prepared for college and, you know, just did a lot of self-discovery and explored and just enjoyed my summer.
I went to Canada.
What did you do in the summer?
Nothing really, just gaming.
I hung out with my friends mostly and just watched scary movies because I wanted it to be fall.
Went to the mall a lot.
I slept a lot.
So I was here for summer school, and I spent some time in Nantucket, Massachusetts, and I played lots of golf, so that was my summer.
But now that we're back in school, do you have a hallway crush, Michael?
Yeah.
What floor do you see them on? You don't have to get into it.
Third and second.
Oh, shoot. Do you have a hallway crush?
No.
Yeah, I do.
What floor?
Well, just gym class.
Oh, shoot. Watch out, gym class. All right.
Nah. No, I'm serious. I don't.
How has this market period gone for you?
Well, so far I've gotten good grades on my test.
It's been okay. I don't like geometry. I hate geometry.
Me too. How was the first market period going so far for you?
Could be better. I've been absent a couple of days. I've been sick, like flu season, you know? So it's been good overall so far, yeah.
All right, thanks, Nicholas. I'll see you. All right, guys. Talk to you. This has been Jeremiah with Just the Jam, and thank you for watching this segment. Tune in next time where we're going to have Spirit Week and Halloween.
Next up, we had an informative and heartfelt talk with Mr. Jacobs, our SAPIS specialist, and Ms. Ezratty, everyone's favorite counselor.
Let's find out how they help our community and what we can do to help ourselves.
Yes, Eshk, it's easy to get overwhelmed, so here are some wise words from the professionals for our mental health.
Hi, this is Adam with Good Day for Us Hills, and I'm here with Mr. Jacobs. What type of student problems do you help within our building?
So I am the school's SAPIS counselor. SAPIS stands for Substance Abuse Prevention Intervention Specialist. So I go into anywhere between 20 and 30 classes a week to teach in the prevention portion of my responsibilities. And for those students that get referred to me for counseling, I also deal with students who have mental health concerns. So I would meet with any student that was in distress or that required some counseling.
What is the best advice you have for students to stay away from these harmful behaviors and substances?
I would say self-awareness is a tool that will take you a long way, as well as the company you keep.
What is your best warnings to students about substance abuse?
Refusal skills. The ability to say no isn't something that comes easily for most people. So my goal through education is to prepare students that they're not caught off guard when someone in the park or someone in their community offers them a vape pen or marijuana or some alcohol in its varying forms.
What can friends look out for to tell if their friend is involved in something harmful or in trouble, and what can they do about it?
If they're isolating or if their behavior has changed and they seem to be hanging out with new friends that might be greater risk takers, and what can you do? You can actually talk to your friend and recommend to that person to maybe come see a counselor such as myself.
Students, so can you demonstrate or explain to us a breathing exercise to help students?
I would usually start out by asking them to either stand or sit up straight in their seat, relax, close their eyes, listen to my voice, pay attention to your breathing, notice whether you're breathing fast or slow, through your nose or through your mouth. Don't judge your breathing, just notice it. So mindfulness is in varying forms. It might be meditation 1 week, it might be breathing another week. It could be a combination of pressure points, tapping pressure points, changing hand positions, mudras, also affirmations. So like today's affirmation, I love me, I am present, and just letting them know, reaffirming that they are valued and that they are worthy.
Where can students find you for help?
If I'm not teaching, I'm in my office in room 214B. That is the boys' side of the building, Gym A side of the building. My schedule is on my door with the exact room numbers of whatever classes I might be teaching from any given period.
Thank you so much, Mr. Jacobs. This is Adam with Good Day for Us Hills. And
thank you, Adam. This is Trina now here with Mrs. Ezratty to have a little talk about mental health. So, Mrs. Ezratty, what service do you provide for our students here at Forest Hills High School?
I am a counselor. I'm a social worker. I provide counseling for individuals and in groups. I am also a facilitator of the GSA in this building. And GSA stands for Gender Sexuality Alliance, otherwise known as the LGBTQ Club.
What is a common challenge that young people face today?
So I actually asked some of my students this question in preparing for this interview. One of the main things, I think, is anxiety. But the other thing that came up was stress, especially for my seniors and juniors, thinking about college, thinking about their next steps. There's a lot of stress around that. And relationships, friendships, romantic relationships, relationships with teachers, relationships with family members. Those seem to be the main things that people are struggling with.
So for people who are looking to help friends, what is a sign that a friend might need some help?
So one of the signs, I think one of the main signs that a friend might need some help, is if they start pulling back from their friends, skipping school, skipping classes, maybe either losing weight, gaining weight, not caring for themselves in the same way, possibly being more irritable, getting, you know, short, blowing up more with their friends.
Finally, what is your best advice for a student who is silently struggling?
So I would hope that nobody struggles in silence. That's my first hope. They are feeling overwhelmed themselves. they are worried that they're going to overwhelm others. And my advice would be, please don't do that. You can speak to the teachers. You can go to your guidance counselors. That's a good first place. Please don't struggle alone. There's always somebody here that can support you so that you shouldn't be alone in that. And the last piece of advice I want to give is to try and practice self-compassion. And what I mean by that is to treat yourself the way you would treat somebody that you love. So if somebody you loved failed a test, you wouldn't necessarily call them stupid. So then don't do that to yourself, right? We have to learn how to be good to ourselves and treat our own selves with kindness.
Thank you so much, Ms. Ezratty, for talking with us today. And I hope this was helpful to anyone who may have been struggling or was dealing with someone who was struggling. Back to you in the studio.
Next up, we want to send out a public service announcement with our own very public service class. Lately in the news has been much talk about subway safety.
We keep hearing about injuries and fatalities of teens from reckless subway behavior.
Let's hear from the public service students on this subject.
So I left my anchor desk to catch up with the winner of the subway safety essay contest. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So I have a few questions for you. Why is subway safety an important topic?
I feel like subway safety is a very important topic because it affects the well-being of, like, in New York City, especially in New York. Live in a world where there is chaos and a lot of, like, unstoppable thefts and a lot of harassments.
This is Lynn, and I also caught up with Ms. Richardson's APS students who wrote essays on subway safety. I'm here with the second place winner. And why is subway safety an important topic to you?
Subway safety is an important topic to me because millions of New Yorkers use public transportation every day, and there are so many different people in this subway system, especially in the trains, and you need to really be aware of everyone and all your surroundings at all times.
Completely agree. What is your message to students about staying safe in the subway?
My biggest message to students is honestly to, if you see something, say something. Don't be oblivious to your surroundings and make sure that when you're traveling, I'd recommend keeping your headphones on a lower volume so you can be aware of your surroundings and what's going on around you.
Thank you. I'm here with the third place winner now. And what are some poor choices or bad behaviors students do on the subways?
Unfortunately, there are bad choices that students decide to make on the subway that I have personally witnessed. Like, I come to school every day using the MTA subway, and I have witnessed students traveling in between cards.
I'm here with another writer who had an honorable mention in the essay contest. What is something you wrote in your essay about how to stay safe in the subway?
I think to be safe in the subway, first of all, you should just always keep to yourself. Be extremely aware of everything that's happening around you, because there are a lot of people, we're still very young, so a lot of people can probably think about exploiting us. Always keep to yourself. Try to be around people that you know. Never talk to strangers. Just be careful.
I'm here with another writer from APS that also got an honorable mention. So, what's something that you wrote in your essay about how to stay safe in the subway?
Well, first off, I wrote about, like, you know, being aware of your surroundings because you never know who's around you and, like, what type of people are, like, behind you or, like, even, like, situations that are going on in the train stations. Make smart decisions because, like, recently there's been a lot of, like, incidents on, like, subway surfing, and that has, like, influenced teens to, like, make stupid decisions which can cost them their lives. A TikTok is not worth your life.
This is Lynn Estava with Good Day Forest Hills saying stay smart and stay safe on the subway.
Good day, Forest Hills.
And now we want to meet our new student government for this year.
Yes, Linaya. Let's get the scoop from these dedicated representatives who are already making big plans for us.
Let's meet them.
Good day, Forest Hills. I'm Ajay Singh, and today I will be interviewing the student government. Now, let's meet our representatives. Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Wes Lau, and I'm this year's co-president.
My name is Dylan Harrop-Williams, and I'm this year's vice president.
Hi, I'm Stefan. I'm this year's secretary for student government.
Hi, I'm Stephanie, and I am the treasurer for this year.
My name is Nicholas Wadia, and I'm the junior governor this year.
My name is Yanzin Shrestha, and I'm the senior appointee for this year.
I'm Linda Yu, and I'm the sophomore governor.
Can you just explain briefly what your job entails?
So my job entails a lot of agenda making for SGO and also a lot of mediating between different members, but overall just leading the student government and all its affairs.
All right, and you?
So the purpose of student government is to act as a voice for the people. So as vice president, it's just my job to do my best to help that, whether it's hearing student concerns, helping make posters throughout the school, and working with other students to increase collaboration.
Of course.
I, along with the team, I work on GOCC meeting notes and the agenda.
I help organize the funding, especially like all the money that comes in for like movie nights or any trivia nights or any events that we host.
All right, that's phenomenal.
As a junior governor, I'm representing the student body of all the juniors and helping to increase the amount of fun events that we have in our school so people can enjoy the school setting.
As a senior appointee, I help out with new members because I've been in the student government for 2 years, and I just help out everyone in general.
Could you tell me a little bit about why you guys got involved in student government?
Yeah, so I actually got involved in student government 4 years ago during online, so it was a shot in the dark. But the journey that I took, it was really inspirational. It was life-changing. I learned a lot of different skills in policymaking, politics, and all these different assets that I would never got otherwise.
The reason I got into student government was because a lot of people said that they weren't feeling at home in the school, or their voice wasn't feeling heard. They didn't feel represented. So I wanted to go change that by joining the student government.
Last year, I felt that the school didn't really have a lot of transparency, and I hope to increase that this year.
I was part of student government in my middle school, and I would like to continue being part of student government until senior year. It's a nice skill for like leadership and communication that could help me in my future.
Now, this is Ms. Kelly, the coordinator for student activities.
Hi, Rangers.
What do you think is special about the student government representatives this year?
One of the things I'm looking forward to this year is that I have a lot of new members of student government, which is going to bring some fresh ideas and perspectives.
What are some upcoming events you think we should be looking forward to?
Some of our bigger events that I know I always really enjoy is in February, we do a talent show called FH Actor. We also have some of our door decorating contests for the winter, our candy cane search. We'll have two other blood drives. And then we're going to have some movie nights thrown in there. We're also looking to get ideas from people, like Disney trivia or sports trivia and things like that. So there's a lot of fun stuff coming up.
That sounds like a year of fun to look forward to.
I hope to make sure that everybody in the school has a fun year and make sure that everybody feels represented.
For this school year, I'm looking forward to being able to judge many fun events. For example, we have the upcoming costume contest.
Something I'm looking forward to personally is the club fair, because I feel like the club fair is just a way that students can feel they learn more about the school's involvement, learn how they can find their own communities, because we have a wide range of clubs. Some years we have like up to 40.
How do you think is the best way for students to get in touch with their representatives?
Well, if I'm using a high school student's mentality, the best way is going to be through social media. We do have our Instagram page. The other best way is to just come right down to room 151, which is where I'm at, and they can always share their ideas here. We also try to post a monthly calendar that has a lot of our events, so you can kind of plan accordingly.
That sounds great. I think you said room 158 it is? Yes, so if you need anything at all, room 158, she's here. This has been Ajay Singh with Good Day Forest Hills. Our student government is putting in a lot of work to make sure these events are perfect. Be sure to check them out. Now, back to you with the studio.
Well, that's all we have time for today. Thanks for tuning in.
Please stay on top of your work as marking period 2 is accumulating grades now.
Next episode, we will have more sports, the fall harvest on October 28th, costumes for Halloween, Thanksgiving wishes, and much more.
This year is flying by already.
Be sure to subscribe to us, Good Day Forest Hills on YouTube.
I'm Lanaya Fuller.
And I'm Eshk Salem, saying
Good Day Forest Hills.